Hey guys, it's Jamie Grace. Welcome to my channel and welcome to my first ever video with my fiance.
Yeah.
Fun fact, I decided to share on Instagram. We shared that we are getting married, which most of you guys might know that before Aaron, I've been single forever and I've never dated anybody or anything. And so a lot of people were like, I'm sorry, what? I went through like Instagram and stuff and I found like the top 10, I think like the most popular. Oh, someone's texting me. I'm speaking of being popular. I feel like I found like the top 10 most popular like questions that people have been asking us about what's happening right now.
Oh, God.
And so we wanted to try to answer some of those questions. And then I have a question for you guys at the end too.
Mm.
Oh. So the first question, people want to know, who is Aaron Collins?
Who am I? Normal guy born and raised in St. Louis, you know, typical jock, you know, played basketball, football, ran track for a year, you know.
So cool. I feel like when people try to figure out like what kind of guy I was going to end up with, they think probably the jock, probably the athlete, probably the cool guy. But you have a sweet side too. You love musicals, which is my favorite.
I love musicals, and I'm actually a really big baby. You know, I cry a lot.
You don't cry a lot. You're just in touch with your emotions in an adequate way.
And I'm deeply afraid of birds.
Next question. How did you guys meet? We met in November of 2016, and it was an event that I was singing at with my older sister, Morgan, and we met at this event.
And it was like a young adult, you know, gathering.
Right. You know? And funny enough, I remember when I was getting ready for the event, I remember putting on eyeshadow because I told my sister, I was like, there's a bunch of young adults here tonight, and there might be like some young Christian single men here. And so I remember I put on eyeshadow when I really know that I need to, you know, get ready. So that's pretty much it. I'll probably only wear eyeshadow on the wedding and or at the wedding and never else, but never else is not a phrase. Anyways, we met there, and then fun fact, we lost touch for what felt like forever.
It was a little over a year, just barely over a year.
Yeah, we I didn't even know his name. I didn't even tell him bye when they left.
I knew her name, of course.
Sorry. we didn't keep in touch or anything. Mm-hmm. It was a crazy year for both of us.
Yep.
And then there was Avaya. How did you reconnect?
Oh my gosh, this is a fun one.
Yeah.
So, you know, one night, I was probably about 12 o'clock in St. Louis, you know.
It was only 10 o'clock on my side of the world. That is my defense.
Anyway.
It was only like 10
anyways,
in California.
I look at my phone, it says Jamie Grace H just followed you. I'm like, oh, okay. Follow her back, you know, and then
to which I went,
a few days went by, and I was like, no, I just want to say thanks, you know, thanks, Jamie, for the follow, you know, and then so I sent her something up in the DM, so saying, hey, thanks, Jamie, for the follow. I spelled her name wrong, by the way.
He did, so which then, I replied, oh, no problem, Erin, which I spelled Erin because that's the level of petty that I oftentimes have in my life. His message wasn't flirty at all. Like, when I followed him, I thought, like, oh, I'm going to give it a couple of days, maybe say hi to him. Like, he's too cute for me. Like, he's not going to say hi back or whatever. So I was like, whatever. And then this was, like, November.
I didn't think you were going to respond. If you were going to respond, you were just going to be like, okay, no problem.
Hilarious, because I was so intentional. But I was like, I can't say anything to him.
Yeah.
So that was, like, November 20th or 22nd. Right before my birthday.
Close to Thanksgiving,
And so he messaged me back, and then I screamed through the house telling my sister Morgan and my friend Kristen, who was staying with us for Thanksgiving, and I was like, he messaged me! And then we just messaged back and forth for a few days, which was it was pretty platonic, I feel like, for the first day. Like, it wasn't anything flirty, and then it turned into, like, we were actually, I feel like there was a few moments where we were, like, spending, like, 30, 40 minutes, like, messaging back really fast.
Oh my gosh.
Like talking about, like, what are you doing for Thanksgiving? Oh, so you cook. And I will be honest and say that I made sure I let him know, like, yes, I did cook.
Oh,
I'm real good at cooking.
I was like, yes. I was like, check.
And so,
okay. Amen.
Yeah. And then on my birthday, which was November 25th, so this is only a few days after messaging, he sent me the sweetest message. Actually.
Okay.
Yeah.
Here's the thing.
Well, okay.
Okay. I knew it was her birthday, and I just really wanted to get to know her better. I was sick of the DMs, and I wanted to just start texting, because I really wanted to make this thing happen. So, on her birthday, you know, I tried to send her a video saying, hey, Jamie, happy birthday, and how much I appreciate you talking to me and all this other stuff, and, you know, and I wanted to get to know you better. And then after I would send a video, I would pretty much just send my number afterwards. So I sent
Fun
that
fact.
And then my number afterwards. But the thing was, the video didn't send.
It didn't send. So it looked like he just sent me his phone number.
Yeah, because she took a minute to respond.
Yeah,
so I was like, oh.
I woke up angry. I was like, no, he did not just send me his phone number. Like,
yeah.
This is a gift? Is my present your
and
number?
And she didn't respond.
Yeah.
So I was like,
and Morgan,
hey, did you
was
get
like,
my video?
Yeah. Oh, even before that, though, me, Morgan, and Kristen, we were giving him the hardest time. Like, he didn't even know it. But Morgan was like, you should text him and say who it is. Like, we were just not. Like, you don't just send a girl your number without saying why you're sending it.
That's definitely not me.
And so eventually he was like, did you get the video? And I was like, oh, there was a video.
Yeah, and then she's talking about some, can you resend this? So I'm like, oh, no, I don't have that video, so I have to remake it.
Mm-hmm.
So my phone didn't have any data, so I had to book it so I could find some Wi-Fi. So I booked it to the first Starbucks. I'm in Chicago.
Thank you, Starbucks.
Michigan Avenue. Thank you, Starbucks. I was running. And then I finally got the Starbucks connected to the Wi-Fi, and I practiced the video probably about 5 times before I sent it.
Which is so funny, because it was like the cutest thing. I'm like, you don't even, whatever. I still have it. Maybe one day I'll share it with you guys.
Oh, gosh.
It was so cute. He like thanked me for talking to him, which I'm like, what are you kidding me? Why, like, don't thank, like, it's an honor to talk to you. So, he sent me that video. I was at Disneyland with my peoples, and my sister and her husband and my friend Kristen, we all planned what I would say back to him. And while they were on the Indiana Jones ride, because that was too scary for me, I sent him a video back, which I thought I was being really flirty and sweet and cute. He thought I was writing him off. I feel really bad about that.
Yeah, because it wasn't too much smiling. I was like, yeah, sure thing. Yeah, I'll send you my number. And I was like, oh,
I
man,
thought,
she really
I was like, in my head, I was like, you are such a flirt. Calm it, girl.
Yeah. It's
but
just...
yeah, I did. I will say that I said something to him that I've always wanted to say to a guy, and I've never really been confident enough to say it, but I said it to him, and he took it so well, which is how I knew that he was a good human. Well, that he was an intentional human. But I said to him, I said, yeah, I'd love to get to know you, but you, I said I'm a little old-fashioned. I was like, I said, so don't text me. You're gonna have to call or FaceTime if you actually want to get to know me.
Yeah.
And then that's what we did for hours for the next few weeks. We just talked and we FaceTimed and we just talked about. I mean, our first conversation, we talked about marriage and intentions and how we neither of us wanted to date just for fun.
Yeah, I had to put it out there because I was like, I'm not gonna waste my time. She's not trying
to
get married. So
right.
I
same
throw it
here.
Out there
I was like, look, if he's afraid of me saying the word marriage, then he's not the person that I would marry. And I'm not about to spend all this emotional energy just talking to him for no reason. And so he also asked me how many kids I wanted to have in our first conversation, which I about cried because I found out that he loves kids and was like interested in one day fostering and adopting, which if you follow my channel, then you know that that is my life. So
yeah, because I used to be a daycare teacher. So, you know what I'm saying? That was my world.
So we're going to have 3,000 children is what we're trying to tell you guys.
Yep. Or if anyone wants to just give us
yes,
their if, kid.
Right, exactly.
You know,
we're open to babysit. Okay.
I'm CPR certified too, so just in case, you know, that helps.
Right,
you know
you're welcome.
So.
How long did you all date?
Oh, well, it didn't date.
We don't really call it dating because it wasn't your normal dating relationship. We count our anniversary as my birthday because it was so intentional. Like, I always prayed for someone that would be very intentional and someone that would say exactly what they wanted and what made sense for their heart. So we count that, and so that will be November 25th, 2017. It was a pretty... When you know, you know! okay, next question. What's the difference between courting and dating? I don't really know a lot about dating because I haven't dated. I had been on dates before with guys, but I had never been on a third date, I don't think. So I don't really have a lot of dating experience. But courting is when you really do know what the intentions are up front and you state those intentions up front. And oftentimes that means that parents will be involved or that other people will be involved. Our parents weren't on our phone calls or anything like that. But, well, except for like when I'm walking around the house and my dad like, what up, Aaron?
Yeah.
Like, you know, like hollering through the phone. And you're like, but yeah, it just means that we are very intentional and we are very open with the people that we trust in our life, his parents and my parents. And just making sure that we knew that it was marriage minded from literally day one.
Yep.
I had a flight on the day after my birthday, and so he talked to me the whole like time from like I got to the airport so early because it was Thanksgiving weekend, and so we talked for like 4 or 5 hours. I don't know how long it was, but I remember boarding the plane and he was asking me, he was like, so what are your thoughts on dating and marriage and or relationships and marriage? I think he said, I'm not sure, but I just remember like. I think that that would be a really intimidating question for a lot of people. And it's okay if that question can overwhelm you because it is a big question. Mm-hmm. But for me, like that was in my head, I was like, no, this guy is looking for a courtship. He's not looking to go out on dates and just see where it goes. Like he already knows what's in his heart. And even if for some incredibly depressing reason we weren't to end up together in the end, courting means that you're treating that person as though they are going to be someone's spouse. Mm-hmm. And so you're not treating that person as though they're mine for right now. You're treating that person as they're like, during our courtship, I treated him like he's going to be someone's husband one day. And he treated me like she's going to be someone's wife someday. And so we just honored each other in that. And made sure that, you know, boundaries and just like respect and honor and all that stuff was a huge part of it. But then, you know, it worked out because he's going to be my husband, so we're good.
Yes, I did that.
I'm so excited. Was it weird having your parents involved?
Actually, no. It was just more so shocking how open they were with it.
I mean, my goodness,
think the first time I mentioned mentioned you to my mom, she was like, really? She wasn't familiar with you. And then I showed her who you were. She's like, oh, okay. She saw you sing with Adele, but like, they were just so open with it. They were really open with me going to LA and meeting with you and your mom and dad. And so they were just shockingly really just open with it. It was just, because it's been a while. So.
Right. Mm-hmm. It was exciting. Like, when he first came out to visit in LA, he asked me, he was like, would you be okay if my mom came? And it was the easiest yes that I've ever given. I was like, of course, because I live with my parents. And I wanted to meet his mom. I'm like, honestly, like to see him around his mom, like that's...
You only get one mama, so remember that.
And I'm like, I want to see how he treats this woman. Like, this is going to be so great for me to see him around his mom. When he first flew out to visit in LA, we hadn't seen each other in over a year and hadn't really talked besides the last, you know, month and a half of FaceTime and phone calls. So when he flew out and I met his mom and I was still terrified and nervous to meet her. But the two of us and his mom, his dad was working, so he stayed back in St. Louis. But and then my mom and dad, we all went out to breakfast.
Yep.
And
with the Denny's.
It was really good. It was just our moms became like best friends.
Best friends, like,
and then like
my mom's a social butterfly.
Right.
You
and
know,
so is my mom. And then we ended up like he and my dad ended up like talking for like hours after that in the car while I went furniture shopping with my mom and his mom because we were in the process of moving to LA from Orange County.
I probably talked to her dad probably more than I talked to Jamie. I mean, it was the best.
I feel like at this point, you and my dad hang out more than you hang out. Like, they talk all the time.
It was amazing. I was not expecting that, but I'm glad it happened the way it did.
So it wasn't weird that our parents were involved in it.
Yeah, not at all.
It was really cool, too, because that was his first time visiting. Yeah. So after he and my dad like hang out for forever, they ended up coming in the furniture store. Crazy story. We'll tell you the full one someday. But they ended up coming in the furniture store where I was with my mom and future mother-in-law. And my dad crept behind Aaron and went like to me, which was the cutest, dorkiest, sweetest, most amazing dad thing I could have ever had experienced, because that was just the moment where I knew that my dad was saying like, you're good, like don't worry, you're good. So yeah, I was excited about that. And that was like January 6th.
And then
the next question, which leads into it, I feel like, is when did you get engaged?
Oh, man.
When did we get engaged, babe?
January 24th.
Yes, we did.
I did that.
We'll tell you guys that story someday. But I will say that this is the hoodie that he wore, and that's why it's massive and doesn't really fit me. But I probably wear this every other day. Like, I just take days off to wash it. But I literally wear this hoodie all the time because it's my favorite now. Mm-hmm. There are many things about, you know, like, for me, especially being single my whole life, like, there are many things that I was, like, excited about and eager about to see what it would be like. One thing was stealing his hoodies.
Oh,
gosh. I told him that before he moved here. I was like, when you get here, like, you're going to have to give me a hoodie. Like, it's going to be a rule.
And ironically, I felt like it was going to be this one. That was the one I got on one knee with. And I was like,
yes, it's the best. Which, fun fact, I may have just thrown in there that he moved here. So literally, he and his mom came to visit for a few days. And then he called me the day after he got home. And he said, your dad said it's okay. And if it's okay with you, I want to do this thing. And I want to move to LA.
Mm-hmm.
And so he's been crashing with family friends ever since.
Yep.
And it's been awesome. Next question. Why did you keep your courtship or engagement private? Okay, so I've shared a significant amount of my life with the world since I was 12 years old, or 13, however old I was when I first started my YouTube channel. And I'm also a pastor's daughter, and so my whole life has been kind of just sharing my life publicly, and it's been an honor and a privilege. With Aaron, I pretty specifically wanted to have something that was just us. Our very first conversation, I told him, I was like, just so you know, I don't post pictures of a guy that I go on a date with, even on my Instagram story. And I think that it ultimately extends greater than me being Jamie Grace or me being a pastor's mm-hmm. daughter. I hope to encourage other young women to know that it's a privilege to say that you belong to someone. It's a privilege for them to say that you belong to them. And if they're not really committing to that, and if that's not an actual commitment, then you don't have to give of yourself, and you don't have to say that it is a commitment if it's not. And so I wanted to wait until we were truly committed to each other forever to really tell people what was going on. And that would be my answer if I were Jamie Grace or not.
Yeah, I think that was the thing too. I wanted to make sure this thing was real, man. Like,
right.
We were like on the same page.
Right,
and,
yeah.
You know, it was just a little weird because, you know, your name carries a lot of weight, and I'll be going, hey, you know, I'm actually talking to Jamie Grace right now. You know, I don't want to sound like I'm boasting, and I just want to keep this one in-house, just close, real close, and with my mom and dad and my sisters, and like they were like the only few that knew. I think my grandma found out eventually, but like I just really wanted to keep this one in-house because I felt it was something different about this one. I just wanted to keep this one close, and timing was a really big thing.
Yeah, which was really overwhelming in the best way for me, because I had been on dates with guys before where, you know, in the date, they start talking about wanting to like single my album, or like, you know, when can I tweet a picture of us and everything. And I'm just like, I had such a hard time with knowing, how do you know when it's real? How do you know when someone's being genuine or honest? And then I met him and I was like, oh, okay, that's how you know. It all made sense. Yeah. Okay, one more question is, are you really having a public wedding? Yes.
Ooh. Oh yeah.
We are. When I was 19 years old, I told my mom and dad that if I'm going to be this open and this public about my singlehood, that I want to be the same way with my marriage, and I want to show people what God can do. This is our wedding is not about us. Our wedding is a time to show people, like, look how good God is. Look how he can do his thing. And so I told Aaron that like right before we got engaged, which we already had our wedding date before we were engaged, fun fact. But like I told him that, I was like, babe, I think I want to do a public wedding, or I thought I wanted to do a public wedding, but I don't want to do it now. I don't want you to feel like you have to live the Jamie Grace life. You know, I don't want you to have to do that. And in the sweetest way, he looked at me and he was like, this is your testimony and you need to share this part of your story. And then he said, plus I'm going to look good in the tux. So there was that. So yeah, you guys, we are having a public wedding.
Please
You're
come out.
You're all invited. I have a song called Party Like a Princess, which is all about my singlehood. And so you can visit partylikeacollins.com and you can RSVP for our wedding and come and celebrate with us. It's going to be in Atlanta, Georgia on April 14th.
Is that lame?
I don't know. I just do that for Atlanta. I'm lame, so maybe that's
I'm from
cool.
St. Louis, you know what I'm saying? Throw the L's up, you know.
I have no idea. But you guys should really come out and celebrate with us. It's going to be a big party where we can just all get together and just celebrate what God has done. And if we can encourage someone out there to wait or to start waiting and to trust that God has an incredible plan for you too, then we are honored by that. So, yeah. Last question, 10th and final question is for you. We want to know, what kind of videos do you want to see from us? If you want to be,
if you guys want to see me, they want me,
right.
I mean,
it might as well, right? So we want to know what kind of videos you want to see. We have an Instagram, what is it? Jamie Grace and Aaron. Jamie Grace and Aaron. So you can follow our Instagram if you want. We haven't posted anything yet because we don't know what to post. So let us know what kind of videos you want to see.
Help us out.
Let us know if you have any more questions about us in the comments, and we'll try to answer them, and we will see you on April 14th.
Yeah.
Bye.
Deuces.
Ciao. Well, you got to do my thing. I say, I love you so much. I'll see you soon. I miss you already. Bye.
Oh. Bye.
Yeah.
How you doing?
Right, left it. Yeah. Wait,
I
do the I'll see you soon. I miss you already. Bye. Hey, you do it.
I love you guys. I miss you so much. Okay, bye.
Bye.
Oh, gosh.
That was fun.